All right. Send this Discord message on out, and away we go. Yeah, I think I said something after last time about today being a more relaxed round, and that somehow ended up being the opposite of the case. The stakes are a lot lower now that we are unfortunately ending our leaderboard run for the season. Losing will usually do that to you. But this guy is doing some interesting stuff. I think today is going to be ugly, but I don't know that it's remotely possible that he can beat me. Some of this stuff we've seen before, but it's kind of... Yeah, we haven't really seen this type of stuff in a while. Like, we have a floating Malik, but he still decided to post Darth Revan on defense. Worse mods with better modding? Oh, my mods are all completely unequipped right now. Don't you worry about my side of the screen. That's... Honestly, that's more just there to give you an idea of what he's working with. Our Darth Revan speeds were tied, which... was interesting, but then we both posted on defense anyway, so that's kind of a non-stat. He added Padme to his defense, which was not a part of his previous defensive playbook, and this Padme is gonna be spicier than usual. They both have a lot of potency. I think I'm still gonna try to get away with nesting this team anyway. But this is, like, already past the point of, like, you shouldn't do this. I'm gonna toss in Hermit Yoda and Watt to try to grease the wheels. But we don't even get to touch that, really, until we see what's behind here. Because I'm expecting, normally, like, in every single week that he's played GAC, there's been a Grievous plus Watt. And there's been a General Skywalker. So, this dude likes to post. And honestly, with even just what I'm showing up front, I don't really know what he can do to break through a wall. Like, he can probably take top. He's got a pretty good JKR Thrawn. But, like, you know, these people aren't really that well built for defense yet. This is, so I kind of switch things up before you really get to remod for them. I'm kind of just... like to think of it as like trying the shoes on just to see how it feels on offense, but you know, I'm not gonna pretend that this Padme is how you should build her for defense just yet. But still, like, he has, assuming that there is Gas and Grievous back here, which I fully am assuming, then I don't know what he can really do to get through me. I do think this is gonna be a very messy round for both of us though. This is kind of what I was thinking we could do. It's a Malik-less, Bastila-less Darth Revan. Unfortunately, I did decide to spend Ahsoka on defense, so Gas will be a floating 501st. I'm not really sure. I didn't even show or pop it up yet, but this Jango Nest team also kind of bringing back an old strategy that I'm kind of happy to see. This is a 340 Nest. My JTR does come out ahead of it, but this is a Relic 5 damage build, offense CD triangle, 316 Jango. Very respectable, and so even though we'll get the opening potential mind tricks on Nest, I still don't know if this is the matchup that we want to handshake, just because their follow-up is going to come so quickly. 316 Jango, 314 Bossk, like, this is going to be some pain. We're gonna either gonna be very reliant on R2 RNG, or we're gonna have to try to change our strategy a bit. Or honestly, I was thinking we could just throw in Gas, but let's knock this out first. I don't anticipate this being an issue, really. Like, my fives is defense modded, so that's kind of a misfit, but we'll see. It's a 338 DR, but we're still even without the Shock T speed lead, we're still plenty of it. I was thinking about it, like, there's no Malik to worry about grenade 8 RNG. We don't have a Bastila kill first. We could just go for HK straight off the bat, and I'm pretty sure no matter who goes next here, yeah, we just automatically get a Sith Trooper Dispel. Honestly, you could probably just pass this back to Rex. Yeah, Marauder being gear 12, he's not really a concern. We could just go for the kill on him first just to shut down his turns, but let's just go for HK. A little bit unfortunate getting Arc Trooper so late. We're gonna miss free turn on him potentially. Oh my, I was not expecting that. I know it's Relic 6 versus Gear 12, but I was not expecting that. My Echo doesn't have good mods on right now. Oh, that's gonna cost us banners. Wow. Okay. Sure. You know what? Yeah, this is an annoying roadblock. To be completely honest. I was kind of leaning something towards this direction. I did opt to post 3PO on defense, which puts us in a much harder position. If we had 3PO right now, this would be fine. Whatever. Huh. Like, gas would kind of be a mulligan. I was thinking Poe is actually decently competitively sped up enough that if we get some decent expose RNG on R2, we could do another chain of 8 expose tier. Heroes are with Rey on defense down here. Heroes would also make this a lot easier. We're working with a budget Rey against a nest that is putting out a lot of pressure. I don't know how I feel about this. This setup feels a little bit weak. I'm going to have Ultra Rey by next lock, which is another big change that's going to switch things up a lot. We're not even going to have R2-D2 now. JTR is almost not even going to be a thing. I don't know what I'm going to do. I would say it's a bit uncomfortable. We could rebel this, but if he has gas in rear and we don't have Han Chewie for the counter, it's going to be uncomfortable. Actually, you know what? I did not do my homework on spec. 240, not that fast. Assuming this is what he locked with. That's actually a little bit spooky. What's up, Deco? The problem is, with gas being so slow, I don't even know that he causes that much disruption here. And, like, up here, another problem is, if, like, I kind of wanted to do Geos, but this Malak is faster than us, so he will very likely get the shock on Geos. So even if we tried to, like, I originally thought, like, oh yeah, Geos, we can just focus on Stormtrooper Hunt, it'll be fine, then we switch Spy to Nuke over here. But whatever team has to handle him is going to have to get ahead of. I don't know, man. I don't know if he really is going full defense or not. All right, let's just... There's going to be some RNG associated with this. This could get ugly. I was thinking we could just go double. Old school Finpo. Problem is, I don't even know why I landed on this build in the first place, but Finn is lacking a lot of speed as a result too. So unless R2 and Poe get some good exposed RNG, it's going to be hard to drag Finn up. But he at least does bring that AoE cleanse. We also rob ourselves of a lead if we do this as well though. Which I don't love. She's about 270. She could just bring us extra murdering prowess. I think we just kind of want resistance trooper. We're going for a double AoE exposes, so this will give us at least two more turns to try to make something happen with him. This does feel pretty uncomfortable. Keeping Finn without Resistance Trooper and Poe already makes this team kind of weaker, but at least they have Relic stats to throw at the wall for something in case we need it. Like, we still have the Daze and Stun to try to handle Nest. Okay. I can see this going real south real quick, but we have to with the information that he's hiding and the fact that he's been a consistent gas Grievous poster, that makes me nervous. All right, let's see. I'm so used to aiming with 3PO for offense down. It's such a... Okay, we got speed down, we got days. Perfect. That's exactly what... It was so nice to be able to spread offense down. We got 1, 2, 3... 3 exposed, that's still pretty good. Let's try to get a 4th here. We did not. Okay. We need at least 2 to get another turn, because Ray's next turn isn't going to be that significant. That's a lot of resists. Our potency is pretty much hitting rock bottom, I think. Ooh, I really, really want that to stun. Okay. This boss isn't going to be as hard to kill as normal, so I don't mind this frenzy timing just yet. We have some control. We just lost that control. Okay. Ooh. Okay. 2 TM blocked, 2 not. R2 about to go, so he should crit. Although this Boba turn timing is really, really spooky. Do we just sacrificial lamb? We could just point this at Poe. Man, Nest is about to go as well. This is Nest AoE. If we don't get dazed, that might actually be good for us. I'm not too crazy about giving up Poe here, but it might buy us some extra time for a resistance trooper to sneak out ahead. Okay, that is not bad for us. This should crit. Okay, we are starting to get back in control. This second Jango turn is crazy scary, so I think we try to shut that down. We still have days. I wouldn't mind trying to get Tenacity down on Nest early with this follow-up, just while it's safe. A bit of healing goes a long way there. Let's just try to set up a stun. Alright, that Dengar happening is pretty inevitable eventually, so it's not a big deal. Okay, most of our bombs are defused. We're just gonna have to auto basic down nests, which is fine. Okay, it's not too concerning. Let's smokescreen just so that we can get this build back up. Ooh, this is looking like a Poe. It's not looking like that, though, apparently. Shame on me for doubting. Alright, let's just cycle this around a bit. I think we have another ID we can probably pop. Try to hit her with something harder. Okay, close. We wanted to try to goose this a little bit for banners. Time is running a lower side than you'd like. We could try to line up an ID just for a bit of health back. We're cutting this rather close. Yeah, no, it's just that. Poe with the kill shot. That's a bit surprising. Okay. So we got through with the minimum budget, and the winner is... Okay. About half. Could... Gas Solidus. Missing a mod. Crit damage still. Offense arrow. I bet Gas could Solidus. There's gonna be a lot of crit. Wait. Huxley being fixed means no counters. That's a little bit spooky. He's gonna get a crit. He's gonna get a big turn off. He's CD modded. Most speeds. 296, well, not 296, 266. Still good speed. He's got double protection primary. We could just flex gas into JKR and make this matchup pretty trivial. At least I assume pretty trivial. It's a decent amount of extra protection for the team. Okay. Let's assume that we can keep the full clear intact. We need to pull Hermeniota out for Padme, which means we could just flex gas instead. Where do we even use Nisus here? We could use Nisus against Hux, I guess. I haven't used CLS against Malik. I actually don't know how that would play. I don't know that no 3PO really matters here. I assume once we get him low enough, his crit avoidance will get high enough that only Hana's gonna get feared a lot. Rebels could one-shot a lot here. Geos would be very happy with this matchup. Okay, I think we can do this. I think we make this work. We're on Padme, right? Let's confirm this. Let's go top down. Their potency thresholds are high enough that this is going to be spooky, but there's going to be some safety harnesses, but those harnesses might not always save us. But this is the cheapest roster-wise. So we have a, let's call it, 3% chance of Nest getting heal blocks, but that will get cleansed by what? Padme has a decent chance of uncleansable stunning her. No 3PO means less opportunities of that, but we'll at least get the protection back at turn start, so even if she can't health steal, there's some safety options here. Just hopefully... I think if we could get, like, Anakin dead, then I think we're okay. We could just clean up with my sisters. Okay. This is about as close to don't try this at home as you can get. I wouldn't call this a desperation, honestly. Let's put this piece on Nest. We have another because reasons? Sure. I actually don't really want to spend this time doing this. Call the assist on GK because it doesn't matter. Lost the target on Anakin. Okay, back on him, back on auto. Yeah, see, Anakin is capable of landing buffs on the beasts. I wonder how long the boss gonna last. Yeah, see, there's the heal block. Now, Nest turn start will cleanse it. Wait, did Nest just attack GK there? Is the targeting screwed? And off again. Big thing that's going to be scary here is a Padme kick it for low. Anakin basic is whatever. Yeah, that Padme kick has about a 3% chance to land. Ooh. No 3PO here means... Oh, come on. no 3PO here means that we could potentially get a Anakin kill much earlier. A purple shield is going to be we need to get that off. And Shock TV here means that we have a lot more protection to need to try to punch through. This is going to be another counter. For a second, I thought that Anakin was about to get counterattacked. Currently at 3 minutes, not looking too bad just yet. Shock's probably going to heal Anakin before this turn, though. No, maybe not. This might be a kill shot. Okay. That is actually a pretty early kill shot, all things considered. Padme kick can still be a little bit scary here. Like, I've seen Ahsoka's and bad hit, or big hits, but not nearly as bad. Even if Shock T heals Padme, it's over. Let's click you, just because you're a pain. Which tech is this again? This is the tank piece. What it does is it cleanses you at the start of your turn and gives you 40% protection back. So in the case of Anakin, Anakin has higher potency than we have tenacity. He has over 100%. So anything over, ideally you need to have as much tenacity as they will potency plus 100%. Anything across that gap is an extra risk. So 52 banners, not great here. This is more just a win in terms of roster efficiency. Because again, I do not think this guy can full clear me. Well, he saved Gas and JKR. What does he even have aside from that? Gas, JKR, JTR. Relic 5, Thrawn. He saved Bastila, so he has EPBSF. Like, even if he could, like... I think he could maybe, if he played his cards right, he could expose this wall, but I don't know what he would have left in the tank to get through this. Like, he could try to CLS them, maybe? I don't know. But yeah, so that tank piece will cleanse everything that Anakin lands off of you, but Padme Kick is still a threat. Because it's uncleansable, but you will at least get the 40% protection back. It's a big risk because you won't be able to take a turn where you... You know, let's say you get heal blocked and stunned. That's a turn where you're not going to get to lifesteal back in time because the stun stops you from flashing back out. But at the very least, that 40% protection is kind of an extra safety blanket there. Do we toss a gas in here just for cleanliness sake? I actually haven't tried this with gas, but I can only assume... It's a great time. We're gonna have gas, or not gas, we're gonna have Wadex build start. So JKR being fast this year is actually pretty nice. Yeah, sure. Now we might need to farm Hux for feet progress, by the way. I haven't even thought about that. If we splash, we risk a B2 activation. I might just... This should one-shot Watt. It did not one-shot Watt. How thoughtful. You know? He's got the self-cleanse piece, though. But I would not mind this taunt just being gone. So even though it's going to come back very shortly... Actually, that's a pretty lucky counterattack. Days on B2 was great. That kick on B2 was extremely not great. That's actually kind of stressful. You just got us very dangerously close to another kill for no good reason. Let's just copy the speed. Why was that buff immunity hidden? You would think that that would be high priority. Like, we could just go for Blender Method and just proc him a bunch right now. We're still two turns away. You know what? Or Anakin's just not gonna crit with 100% crit chance. Sure. Celebrate your life choices. Jolie, I don't know if Jolie can take this heat. That kill is fine. Don't care about that kill. You really just had to decide to kill him now, didn't you? Of all of the times, now was just the timing you wanted to go for. Son of a bitch, Cass. Twice you decide not to crit. Be a real shame if this was the one. He actually made this harder. We're gonna lose the counterattack chance, so I don't think we get a chance of rallying back to this. This does pretty bad. We can play this out. We got the one kill, so we'll just clock it in. But... wow. I don't think this really changes anything. Like, 100% this next GD turn is gonna knock him out. I don't think there's any way that we can. This is only target other. This is only 30% heal. God, of all the times to throw that Magna Guard into a blunder. Okay. Second time in 2 weeks, what? Now, I was trying JKR Gas GM1, as I needed to save Hyoda for Nest against Padme, and the power ended up being too much for me to handle. You know what? Like, I'm pretty sure we can't self-target this, well, this is just gonna be a basic command anyway. Why not? GG Terminator was lower because I did that. Better than timing out. Could just NS this. Yeah, I don't know, maybe floating gas, but we didn't really have a fifth Jedi to run otherwise. We could have done Old Ben. Old Ben actually would have been a lot cleaner for that fight. If we had Old Ben, that Magna Guard doesn't die and JKR just marks Grievous instead. Damn. Yeah, that would have been a cleaner play, I think. We saved Finn, we still have Rebels. I actually was kind of thinking about this. I think this might actually be a really good matchup for this setup. Right? We're gonna have such a good protection regen engine. We don't have Watt. Newt has the Dispel. Malak has a Dispel. The biggest threat is going to be if Bossk lines up a turn where they're weakest. Like, if we can if we fail the condition on Bossk Retaunt, then we're in a little bit of trouble. But actually, no, I still think that this checks out. We could toss in Old Ben here just for protection's sake. I almost clicked better in. Hey, where are you at? Here. I mean, we could just throw in CLS for runes. Yeah, I think this team has a better shot at eating protection from Malak than a CLS lead would. I actually don't mind, hate the idea of Old Ben instead of CLS, but no. This is as easy as amount. We'll get Terminator gains on him. I'm just going to park him in defense stance. We'll get a bunch of Bossk lead regen. I don't see this really going poorly. Biggest danger is actually just going to be Bossk first turn, because he's definitely getting stunned. 1-1 is pretty slow, though. We could shoot Dooku instead of Droidica. You know, sure. His Terminator being low, if we snapshot, we could just kill him right now, or we could just... And then do this. We could handshake a fear Chewie just to stop Malak. I actually didn't even think about the fact that our Bossk was so no open taunt. Well, that failed. Okay, I actually don't mind extortion. Oh, I didn't even think about that. CLS was actually built for guard, so we stole it from Bossk. I actually don't think it matters here. We care just about the protection regen, not everything else going on here. Okay. We just fish for it again? I mean, we could just... Let's stop any Terminator happening first. Oh! If we leave... Okay, we need Newt to stay alive. If we kill Newt and leave Malak last man standing, Bossk Zeta Unique won't apply. Okay, we have to do this. Okay, so far... Working as intended. Need to get him some debuffs if we can. Even with Tenacity down, you're just not in the mood to land any debuffs, are you? What? Oh, he must have fallen below. It's a gear 12 Newt, though. Is his half really lower than this? There's no way. Oh, he had shock. Oh. Okay, his next turn will self-bind, so we'll be back in business. No imminent danger. Oh, someone had extortion that we didn't self-bind on. And fine. You can get all the crit damage he wants. Do we even bother fighting this at this point? We have 5-man extortion. Did someone get stunned and I didn't realize it? Yeah, you're great. I feel like by doing this, we're just wasting so much time. This is a really annoying position to be in. I think we just need to take him down. Okay, no, this is actually legit playable. Who the heck got payout that I missed? I might have missed it because of the guard symbol. At this point, he legit just has full win on us if we ignore him. But if we don't ignore him, then we lose the taunt anyway.
very annoying.
He's gonna be stealth Chewy next turn. Well, at least we're kill him. He might actually just straight up kill Vandor. We have to do this for health. Damn. Until that happened, this actually looked pretty sustainable. I think we had the win. We had him down to like 40% health. It was gonna take a minute, but we had 2 minutes. And maybe this is still doable. Stun? Okay, I guess this is still a thing. Fair enough. The moment that we took Nude out, it stabilized. God, that sucked though. I kind of want to go back and check who I missed. It had to have been when Bosk was shocked, I think. Or no, it might have been Bosk had payout and just bled to somebody else. Vandor. Bosk didn't have it though. Okay, no, this is actually weird. I'm pulling this up. Where did this actually start? Because even, like, I'm watching, like, even on other characters, I wasn't just spamming it on Bosk. Like, I actually had this. My internet actually wants to work. Oh, god. Great. 3 minutes left, we don't have it. Yeah, it was when Bosk got shocked. Damn, fair enough. I mean, we still won anyways, who cares? But that was weird. That was not a fight you would normally see. That's kind of cool. I don't think there's anything to really say about this matchup. Geos are just so overqualified to deal with the Zalbar L3 double taunt that it's just honestly kind of gross. I don't think they're gonna kill Brute. Let's just do this for best banner business. Alfie just patiently waiting for her turn. How nice of her. No need to taunt with Sunfac. We'll let the Brute take all the heat. His banners don't count. He's starting to tax us a little bit. Let's waste some time on Zalbar just so we can try to get some protection back on assists. Hearth Terminator is low. Anyway. Ooh. Okay, this debuff bomb being so big actually means we're gonna get taxed pretty hard if they actually do get to take a turn. So I think we need to take out Karth now to keep the rest of our team up high. Oh damn, the Zalbar assists. The Zalbar counter. Okay. His defense is going to be pretty stacked. I think we get a little defense. Everyone's just gonna, like, pretty much just try to inch into the Grease period if they aren't already. So, yeah, okay, we got it. We got 60. I'm so grateful for stacking defense right now. How? He actually got to take a turn. Okay, we're back at 55. And he's also extremely squishy now. Damn. Okay. We had that. I think I needed to finish that with a Spy Nuke, or at least try to. Once I knew that we had 60 in the bag, I think that was why let Newt live for so long? Because Newt being there was actually keeping Bosk Taunt Zeta alive. Newt only became a problem once I slipped up and when Boss got shocked on the one turn and he put it in on Han, I did not catch it. Right, so if we, like, this is actually pretty much the same thinking as the Malevolence video last night. The weakest person has to have protection for his taunt to stay up. So by Newt being there, and I stopped hitting him before he ran out of protection, as long as Newt was present, that meant that we got to keep the taunt. And honestly, like, while we were juggling extortion properly, like, Newt wasn't really a character. Like, when he was placing it on Bossk, it wasn't a big deal. Like, Bossk got so much regen that 20% of his health on that protection was not a big deal. Again, if we slipped up on, or if we didn't slip up on Han, like, I would have been plenty happy to kill Malak first, leave Newt alone. Although at one point, there would have been a point where Malak was low enough health that Newt wouldn't have been the weakest person, so that would have happened anyway. Or Boss Tom would have dropped eventually. I am probably the sisters. Zombie kill first, that's pretty fortunate. Some good resisting out of gate. Some good resisting out of gate. Some good. This dude isn't unkillable. The god. Okay, there we go. We're unstunnable. I don't think zombies even done one sacrifice yet. Let's just. For go right now? I'm trying to get this dude to cooperate without putting Grievous below 100% health. Not really going the way I wanted. Because I'm pretty sure Grievous is just going to mark. That works. That revive sucked, though. Okay, we get a little bit of ping pong here, but this ping pong is gonna very, very quickly lead to a pissed off Grievous. Alright. We need this bouncing stun to land. And just for safety's sake, let's top off Taka. Just try to cycle time. I'm impressed. I mean, that B2 had tenacity modding and then B1 giving him extra tenacity, but I really figured Mother Talzin Leeds extra potency, we were going to get some good traction early. That dude resisted like 9 out of the first 10. Okay, knowing that today is going to be messy, if we just want to take next rush. It is Biggs, Wedge, or Vader, right? As I recall, we could just try to feed Vader a whole bunch here. I mean, well, no, it's not cruelly, that's actually different. Okay, we can do this. Debuffs, not a concern. I don't know if Gear 13 Scion is gonna have trouble not murdering them here. We could just do Nihilus for cooldown control. I don't hate that. I like Thrawn. Thrawn's gonna get us more Vader opportunities. Yeah, sure. Let's go with that. Okay. Almost immediately, we want a AV crit. Let's go fishing, maybe? Or we could just... Yeah. Dominance gone. CDM out. Everything looking pretty good for it. Vader didn't get self-cycled, but honestly, kind of. We got Fracture here. I'd almost like Isolate here just for the anti-turn meter. You could call placing Isolate on Vader this early a bit of a miscast, I think, technically, but the way I see it. Do we want AoE Lightning? For trying to funnel Vader, I don't know if we actually want to end that quick. Although, for Spreading Shock, that's kind of hitting the same effect. Let's whittle them down first. Boy, finally got damage. Honestly, another point was to funnel Vader, but it's good. Okay. Leave my turn meter alone. I'll leave you alone. Okay, one kill. If we get four, we'll be 8 out of 12. I'll take that. Swap Vader again. I don't think he's getting a kill. Foss is looking workable. Yeah. You just had to do it, didn't you? I'm honestly surprised that he got the cooldown. Stunnable, I'll take it. Although, I think Vader's gonna have to go for a kill. I actually don't know. So Palpatine does damage equal to 20% of their HP. I don't know if they're, that actually counts as percent HP damage for their resistances. Sure. We can buy some time on Faust. That time to buy it very quickly. Okay. This is just a hole. Palpatine AoE is lower damage. This might actually be... Come on, dude! Fair enough. Alright, we got another Malevolence. We can try to just straight up play around this concept now. Let's... I still think Sergeant might be safer. My Sergeant is not great. We'll do Plo Koon opener, Clone Sergeant last. Clone Sergeant will probably take some Buzz Droid heat, just inevitably. I don't think we can fully stop them from doing it. But yeah, we just gotta get to Malevolence ult. Sure. One thing we definitely have to avoid, especially like we use Plo Koon Cleanse on Houndstooth. Houndstooth already has himself taken care of with basic. Let's just do this. I think somehow magically ships is going to end up being our best banner efficiency of the night, which is not a statement I ever intended to make on this channel. Okay, let's just put Breach over here. Let's just miss Breach entirely. I was trying to decide, like, do I still think I want to go for an AoE damage opener? Because this can get real savage real quick if you like. I still think maybe, yeah. That looks like Plague Symbol. I swear I just saw Plague. Right, so, like, we have triple target lock right now. We could hit this, and it's gonna really badly. I don't know if we want to do that. Let's try not doing it. Just see how this feels. That didn't feel great. Okay, if he does stun, it's gonna have to be on. Let's do this to chip away the tanks, we'll leave. You're really not supposed to leave the Vulture Goids alone. This is odd. Let's pop Terminator. This will give Anakin better acceleration. I really wanted to leave Sunfac alive. I wanted to kill anything that made Vulture Droids or Buzz Droids. And leave the Geos alone. Geos were our friends. I guess it's just not going to play them. Let's take Hyena out of the equation first. Not a huge fan of Plo Koon being threatened right now. Could just try to AoE wipe to it once. A lot of damage on Spy though. Houndstooth is gonna self-taunt or self-cleanse first. This is fine. We're back in business. Taunt is gonna go away then. Clone Sergeant coming in. We're still gonna have two taunts. They won't necessarily go for what. Three Buzz Roys being out is a bit spooky. Did he not? Because of the taunt, he didn't go into stealth. Unfortunate. I kind of would have liked to have put that breach on Spy, I think. What if we just, like, push the taunt out? This is, like, now that we're actively playing around this from the start, this is a much weirder fight. This was a lot easier when you were just, like, halfway through, had the idea. Let's do some more Vulture Control. 2,000, that's fine. Ooh. I didn't look at Clone Sergeant there. I didn't realize he was in trouble. Unless that was just a huge hit from Spy for reasons. It might be the case that this is just a hard fight to slow burn. Although this is a much messier fight than the last one that we did. Let's see. Anakin gets pissed off. Put the buff here. Spy stays vulnerable. That's just pretty much an instant. Banner is not going to be good though. Interesting. Okay, I think I slow burned that a little bit too hard. That's a big difference between this fight and last one. Yeah, this is 5 banners lower. Yeah, the biggest difference between this and last one is last one, I, like, blew everything immediately. Like, that 5's triple AoE that I pointed out. 1878, we did have a fail. Still not a great score. Yeah, Miyabaka, holy shit, that beat too was ridiculous. Like, dude, I knew he was Tenacity build, but, like, my nice sisters should still have mods on them. I mean, they're not the craziest mod, but still. 199% potency with Talzin lead. God, yeah. That was, that BT was a god. Alright, well, I'm happy that I got the full clear. Honestly, even with the messy score, this is a bit better than I expected. I thought that there would be more jank. I honestly didn't think that the JKR gas flex was going to be the problem point. again, that, like, the B2 didn't even have a 6-dot crit avoidance arrow, but somehow Gas first turn just straight up did not crit him when we wanted it to, and then the second turn just one-shot him entirely. Insane. Moral of the story, Jedi, when you can't control your pacing, which Gas absolutely doesn't have an off switch with crit damage build, not fun. Not fun when you throw your team into a blunder. Not sure why I'm slow playing. I'm slow playing to try to avoid killing them too quickly. The thing I was worried about, if I just pull this up and get this to live. Because I do this exact thing all the time in Fleet Arena. This scenario, pre-plow. At the start, you do your AoE, you get triple target lock. It's very easy to just close the match out right here. I was a bit worried that it was going to be too much damage. I don't think that was a safe, or I don't think that was a fair thing to worry about in hindsight. But this is, it's still a new concept. Like, playing slow against some loved ones is something I don't think a lot of people have ever really tried to do before, period. Yeah, I, like, if we killed Hyena first, and then the Vultures and left Sunfac alone, that would be pretty hard. That. Like, I think, let's look at Anakin's turn. Yeah. Okay. Normally, I put the block targeting on Hyena so I can hit Sunfac in the arena. I think we flipped that. Sunfac is a ship that I really don't mind ignoring. Yeah, he can get the stun once every 3 turns, I think. But if that's going on Hounds too, like, kind of, who cares? Like, we could try to stack both buff immunity and breach on Sunfac, and as long as Hyena has debuffs, there is a 50-50 bet that will get left alone. The only problem is, Hyena is so much tankier than Sunfac too. Like, this AoE tends to hurt Sunfac way more than Hyena. Hyena gets down to maybe like 60%. Oh yeah, what the hell happened with Sergeant? I actually do want to see this. I'm not crazy. I knew that, like, just on peripheral vision, I knew that he was, like, coasting. Like, yeah, the buzz droids are there, but just, like, one overcharge here, no overcharge here, and then, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's just because we procced a spy. I think this is like a 30% offense bump. Mm-hmm. 10% for each active geo ally, plus 30%, oh, it's 30% crit damage on offense. What a god. Like, I knew it wasn't crazy. It's like, Gold Sergeant hasn't been taking heat here. That was the first time I tested him. Like, if we could take out Spy, like, if we could manage that and leave Sunfac in and just have Sunfac be the anchor. Like, Sunfac is easily the lowest impact ship in the game if he's not able to taunt. Or not in the game, but just, like, that you would fight in this matchup. Interesting. More to think about. I think we go harder than we did this time, but less hard than we did last time. Try to aim the buffs a little bit better. I think we take that opening AoE game. I really don't want to leave it so that the only ships that we have left are buzz droid ships. Like, if we have to leave a Hyena alive, that seems really uncomfortable, honestly. Yeah, this plus 50% defense just makes it so much longer to kill him than dealing with Sunfac ship. Alright, well, good luck to this dude, honestly. He has a lot on my defense to get through. That was partly why today went so messy. Like, I knew he was going to post Darth Revan, and I ended up choosing to post Padme and my own Darth Revan anyway. But kind of worked out. I got the full clear. I really went into today not knowing the full clear was going to be here because I played around gasping back here. This I was expecting. This I was. But the dude has a lot to work with, or a lot to deal with. So we'll see what happens. I have a lot of. Like, I basically have to reinvent my strategy for next week because I'll have Ray ult. That's going to change a lot of teams. I don't even know if I'm going to have a JTR anymore. There's a lot of rebounding to do. I still don't even have a tank to pair with Ray either, which is the worst. I really don't want to put Holdo to Relic 7. I don't have to. But, like, Barriss, it's... Like, we're getting some gear for her. Like, we're getting there. Like, we could do this. But this doesn't feel like a surefire investment. Like... Okay, I have a party bite. Need to look into this off stream before I talk about it. Okay. That's a Grand Arena stream. That was something. Messy. Fast. Yeah. See you next week. Peace out.